Afternoon, friends. Still, we have some more problems in game theory. We have here three rows and three columns. So, finding a row minimum. So, at the end of each row, we are writing the minimum values. So, that minimum value of 1 is present in both this place at this place. So, writing that. So, similarly for the other two rows, writing the minimum value, so that is minus 4 here and then minus 2 here. Similarly, at the end of each column, we are writing the maximum values of each column, then taking the maximin value and minimax value. So, here we are having maximin. So, among all the minimum values, taking the maximum of it, so that is 1. So, among all the values here, so maximum values for the loser, that is player B, so we are taking minimum out of that, so that is 1. Since this maximin is equal to minimax, we say that the game is having the saddle point. So optimal strategy for player A, so 1, that is the value of the game, so that is present in the first row. So, we are taking the first row as the optimal strategy for player A. This minimax is present in both the columns 1 and 3. So, optimal strategy for player B is either column number 1 or column number 3. So, value of the game as written here, so it is 1. Then now, games without saddle points. Now we'll take a game of the size 2x2. So player A is also having two options. So that is A1, A2. Player B is also having only two options, B1 and B2. Either has to choose this column or this column. Similarly, for player A, he has to choose the first row or the second row. If P1 is the probability that player A goes for his first row, so 1 minus P1 is the probability that he will go for the second row. Similarly, if I take Q1 as the probability that player B goes for his first strategy, 1 minus Q is the probability that he is going for his second strategy, that is column number 2. So, the matrix is given in the form AB in the first row and CD in the second row. So, we have the formulas here to find the probability P and Q here. So, the formulas are given here for P, Q and V. So, that is the value of the game. To summarize, so P is the probability that player A goes for his first row or the first strategy. So 1 minus P is the probability that he will go for his second strategy. Similarly, out of the two columns, either player B has to go for column 1 or column 2. If Q is the probability that he will choose his first column, so 1 minus Q is the probability that he will choose the second column. So what is the output of the game? So that is value of the game. So for that, the formula is here. Now we'll see how to solve that 2x2 game. So that is written in the form of AB, C and D. First, we have to check whether saddle point is there or not. So as usual, we'll find minimum in each row and maximum in each column. Then we have to check whether maximin is equal to minimax. So here, maximin is not equal to minimax. We say that the game is having no saddle point. Now, so then we have to take the value of the game using the formula here. So this, so we are getting this and optimal strategy. So here we have to take A value, B, C and D. So find out the probability P and Q here. So if if the same game is played for 15 times, so the player A will go for his first strategy four times. So what is the probability that he will choose his second row? So it is 15 minus 4, so that is 11. So it is 11 by 15. So that is, if the game is played 15 times, so the player A will go for his first row for 4 times, and he will go for his second strategy 11 times. So that means he feels that his second strategy is more beneficial to him. So Q is the probability that player B chooses his first column. So that is 4 by 15 again. That is, if that game is played 15 number of times, so player B goes for his first strategy 4 times. So what is the probability that he will go for his second strategy? It is 15 minus 4, so that is 11 by 15. So value of the game is also calculated here. So if the value of the game is positive, we say that the game is favorable to player A. If the value of the game is negative, so we say that the game is favorable to player B. Thank you.